The presence of invasive shothole borers on your property isn't necessarily a death sentence for your trees. It's true that these beetles and their associated fungi can devastate a large area of trees in a few short years, but it is also true that with proper management practices, many trees can be saved, and even heavily infested areas can recover over time. Early detection is key to success, which is why an active monitoring program is highly recommended. In most cases, trees with light to moderate infestations can be managed by pruning infested branches and continuing to observe the tree's health over time. To prevent spreading fungi, you can protect the tree wound by spraying it with Bacillus subtilis, also known as hay or grass bacillus. You should always disinfect your pruning tools after use with a solution of 70% ethanol, 5% bleach, or Lysol disinfectant. Depending on the location and other factors such as tree species and value, infestation level, and hazard level, chemical pesticides also may be appropriate treatments. Trees that aren't already infested should be monitored but not treated. Heavily infested trees that have more than 150 entry holes and signs of dieback can be a major source of beetles for other trees in the area. They can also be hazardous as fungal and beetle tunneling activity can compromise the tree's structure. Known as amplifier trees, these heavily infested trees should be removed completely, cutting the stump down to the ground and even grinding it if possible. Removal of amplifier trees is important because you want more lightly infested trees to have a chance to recover. If these trees are constantly being attacked, they won't have that opportunity. We have witnessed substantial recovery in lightly to moderately infested trees in areas where amplifier trees have been removed. The green waste generated by branch and tree removals should be chipped as small as possible. Chipping to 1 inch kills 99.9% of the beetles. If that's not possible, chipping to 3 inches or less will still kill 98% of the beetles. It's actually the violent shaking of the chipper that is mostly responsible for killing the pests. If your area is already heavily infested, you can use that chipped wood on site as mulch. However, if your area is not heavily infested or if you plan to move wood chips to another area, we recommend that you combine chipping with solarization or composting, which will effectively kill 100% of the beetles. Solarization involves covering the material with clear plastic and letting the sun do the work for you. Chips should remain covered for at least 6 weeks during the summer, or at least 6 months between September and June. Unchipped logs can also be solarized, but you will want to keep the depth of the pile relatively shallow, no more than 30 inches deep. Composting should be done at a professional composting facility that has earned the U.S. Composting Council's seal of testing assurance. If you are transporting wood or other green waste, always keep your load covered while in transit. Otherwise, beetles may escape and spread to other areas.